Philippians chapter 1. My fame, your gain. Anybody here went through some difficult times? Brother Kip shared his testimony, but all of us, if we're truthful, can say that God has brought us through some tribulations and some difficulties. Amen. If you haven't been there, just keep on living. I was trying to think about some difficult times in my life, and I've had many, but I can remember when I left high school in 1986. It's my first time leaving Youngstown, Ohio. For those who've been in Youngstown all of your life, you know that it's, if you've been outside of Youngstown, you go outside of Youngstown, it's a whole new world. And so I went to pursue a football career in Middle Tennessee State University in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. And I went there not knowing what would be before me. And so I went as a freshman, I walked on, which is very difficult. So to a walk on is basically when you go to school and you have to pay your own way. You're not going by scholarship. So I went down to Tennessee by faith, believing that I was good enough to make the team. We practiced, and it was 46 of us who started off as freshmen. Many of those were All-Americans from all over, you know, the U.S. And so I went in as a freshman, about 155 pounds strong. I said, I'm going to show these guys that I know how to play. I said, that's that Youngstown in you. If you got Youngstown in you, no matter how big you are, you can fall just like everybody else. So I remember we went through our freshman year and had a great red shirt year. I was a red shirt, which means that you basically are the dummy squad. You get to go against the first team and they can beat up on you, or you can beat up on them. And so I was playing receiver, and they would beat up on me a little bit, but I caught the ball very well. And so I just knew the second year, by the time it was getting ready to register, I was registering. And at that time, y'all young people, y'all know nothing about this. At that time, you had to register, you had a card. And basically, the class was a card. And if you didn't have the card, you didn't have the class. And so as athletes, we had the first pick of our classes. So you go around early and you pick all the cards or the classes that you want. And then you have to go through a series of things. And then ultimately, you end up at the end, you have to pay for everything. Now, when you're on scholarship, what happens is you give the cards to the people, and the people will look it up, and then you cover it. And so I had a great freshman year, and I thought in my mind, definitely, I'm going to be on scholarship. So I got my card and made it to the end of the registration, gave my card to the register, and I said, they were looking in the system, and they said, sorry, but there is no money here for you. I said, what? This has got to be a mistake. After all, I was tearing up the first team. They definitely have to have me on scholarship. Can you look again? They looked again and said, sorry, Mr. Donaldson, there is nothing here for you. At the registration, it was in the same office as the head coach, was Bruce Garland. And so and I knocked on the door, he turned around. He was smoking a cigarette, sitting in the chair at his office. And I said, "Coach, there's a mistake. I said, I went to register, and there is no money down there for me. I said, I thought that I was on a scholarship. I said, you told me that if I did well, or as a freshman, as a walk-on, I would be on a scholarship." And Coach Donnelly, in only the Coach Donnelly type of way, looked at me, and he leaned back, and he said, "What makes you think that you're good enough for a scholarship?" And I said, "Nothing." I stood before him and I broke down in tears. I left that office dejected. I was thinking,